Hey, what's up, guys? Bloody Jacob here to bring you a pretty different video subject here today, but one I wanted to talk about nonetheless, and that is giving my thoughts on the Miss Americana Taylor Swift Netflix documentary, which came out, I think it was back in January or just at the beginning of this month, I believe.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Bloody Jacob here, meeting my icon, Catherine Isabel.
Hey, I'm Sylvia Saska.
And I'm Jen Saska.
And we're the Saska Sisters.
I'll admit, I used to be a pretty big Swiftie, pretty big Taylor Swift fan myself. I mean, I especially liked her early work. I wasn't, digging her quite as much when she went into more of a, pop direction. I kind of liked her more, country-oriented music and such. But I still bought a couple of her albums, and there are a couple songs here and there of hers I don't mind these days. But I'll be honest, there were a lot of late nights when I was a little bit younger where I'd listen to teardrops on my guitar and things like that. And I've always been an admirer of Taylor Swift, so I always thought she seems to be a good person. She seems to be genuine and not just a marketing thing that she's promoted to be or something. So when I seen that she was actually doing this, I was very interested, and I kind of watched it almost on a whim. I mean, I wanted to watch it at some point, but I just left it on because I felt like I was just in a mood. But I gotta tell you, Miss Americana, Taylor Swift, I really, really thought this was utterly a fantastic documentary. I honestly loved it. It's definitely our most genuine look at Taylor Swift yet, and it covers the period in her life, just within the past few years, where she's she kind of dropped off the map for that year or so. It goes into what was going on with her head during that, the bullshit with that Kanye West tried to put her through, and how I've really admired her recently, where she spoke out against, I think it was Blackburn, the mayor in Tennessee, and basically fuck Donald Trump as well, right? I'm not meaning to get too political on this channel, and I know some people will and probably have criticized Taylor Swift. Oh, she just needs to make music, we don't care about what she thinks about politics or whatever. But it's the same way with like Robert De Niro too. They're people too. They live in this country. Just because they make more money doesn't mean they're not allowed to care. And if they have such a high platform, they can use that to voice their opinions and try to start some good movements or speak out against what they believe is wrong, because why can't they? And Taylor Swift definitely can. So I really loved and appreciated that she spoke out against both of them in this way, and just kind of standing up for love and equality in general. And I thought it came across as completely genuine, and I really loved that part of it. The documentary's not entirely about that, though. It's kind of goes through quite a few bullet points of just her journey throughout her career as well. You get a lot of stuff with her mom, and her mom having cancer and stuff like that. And as far as I know, I don't know if they're always planning on doing a Taylor Swift documentary or not, but this is some footage I think they weren't necessarily planning on ever using in anything, at least for the most part. There's probably some things that they intended eventually, but it still, I thought, was pieced together quite nicely. I mean, it's like an hour and a half, but I swear it went by pretty fast, and before I knew it, I had like half an hour left of it. So really, I've never lost, likeness for Taylor Swift, but this has got me sort of resurged into, not just enjoying her music again, but really believing in her as a person. I do think she is a true inspiration. You see some of her highs and her lows in this movie. Just how outspoken she was against even her publicist, and, you know, timing of it, and not caring if President Trump went after her or whoever else, and really rising to believe that. Yeah, I'm not going to explain it the right way, but, you know, just to believe that none of it's, you know, she shouldn't have to be controlled by what's perceived to be as, like, the nice girl thing to do, or, like, what's her place. She kind of breaks out of that. And, you know, she's a human, too. She has, you know, she's dealt with, you know, probably moments of depression and, you know, all this crap falling down on her, but she, you know, and again, it's explained better in the documentary. I'm not really talking about the right way, but I was motivated by this. I felt inspired. I'll admit I almost teared up a little bit, and, you know, comment below if you think that's ridiculous, but I honestly love Miss America. I hope they kind of do some DVD Blu-ray releases or something like that. I would think they might, because of it, you know, playing at an actual festival and stuff like that, but either way, I really do think this movie is worth your time, especially if you're a fan of Taylor Swift, even if you're not. I urge you to at least give it a chance and watch it. Maybe it'll sort of open your mind up about, you know, what kind of person she actually is. But some people probably just think it's bullshit anyway, but I loved it. I thought it was pretty authentic. Give me an A, if not an A+. It's, you know, it's hard to put up with, like, regular films this year, but I feel like it could be on my list if I were to include it. I'm a Swiftie. I'm always going to be a Swiftie. I think Taylor Swift is a pretty fantastic person, as far as I can tell. So, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, like, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.